We hope you are well. Today, we have prepared a video for you on how to solve the problem that usually occurs when configuring a Wi-Fi repeater that does not allow us to access the internet. It often happens that sometimes we are in a hurry and do not pay attention to the configuration data, and this type of problem occurs. We are going to carry out this quick configuration process to connect to the repeater's network and enter the configuration. Enter the username and password admin. Access repeater mode. At this point, we must realize that if the repeater detects wireless signals, apparently the Wi-Fi module works well. If it does not detect your signal, try to search for the repeater closest to the Wi-Fi network that you want to repeat to do the configuration. Select the Wi-Fi network that you want to repeat. This part is very important, and it checks how a name appears for the new Wi-Fi network that is the same as the name of the original network but ends in lowbar and ext. You can modify this name, but you must first take into account that it is not very long. Avoid more than 15 or 20 characters, and secondly, avoid that it may have symbols or special characters that are not recognized later. In the second field, you must write the password of the Wi-Fi network to which you are going to connect, and that will also be the password of the new Wi-Fi network. Also, avoid that this password is too long or has special symbols or characters. You should also bear in mind that the repeater does not know if the password you write is correct or not, so it will not give you an error message if you make a mistake with your password. In this example, we have entered the wrong password to see what happens. We go to the section of Wi-Fi networks to connect to the new network. And we wrote the access password that we thought was the correct one. The repeater will be left in a loop, trying to connect but unable to access the internet. All the time can be spent like this, without connecting to the internet and without giving us any error message in the configuration. The only way to get it back to its initial mode is to reset it. We repeat the same process to connect to the repeater. Select repeater mode to search for nearby signals. Wait a few seconds. Choose your Wi-Fi network from the list with a short name and without symbols in the name of the Wi-Fi network and the correct initial router password, taking care that it is not too long or with special characters, it should work for you. Apply the changes and access the wireless networks. Retype the same access password of the router to which we are connecting, and remember that both will have the same password. Check how in this way you will connect to the new Wi-Fi network and established connection will appear. So, we have internet access. If you are still unable to connect in this way, focus on the issuing router above all to check if it has any type of protection, such as IP or MAC filtering, has the DHCP service disabled, or some other configuration that prevents the connection of the repeater.